The Constitutional Court last week ruled that Sections 5 and 10 of the Public Order Management Act of 2013 are null and void since they penalize organizing and participating in peaceful public meetings, including demonstrations and assemblies. Addressing media today, police spokesperson Fred Enanga, however, insisted that the police will continue dispersing all illegal gatherings, explaining that Section 5 of the Public Order Management Act states that one ought to seek permission before organizing these assemblies.
Organizers of assemblies and processions, individuals and political groups should know that although it's a fundamental right to peacefully assemble, they also have a duty to inform the police as per the requirements of Section 5 about the date, time, details of the organizers, the location and consent of the venue owner, number of persons expected, purpose, and any other basic information.
Enanga further explains that Section 68 of the Penal Code Act also provides for a proclamation for rioters to disperse done by a magistrate or any police officer at the rank of inspector, all above, or any commissioned officer in the armed forces in whose view 12 or more persons are riotously assembled and can make a proclamation and cause for the dispersal of the assembly.
We've seen situations whereby people, wherever a police officer, a commissioned officer is trying to make a proclamation, there are people who try to come out and block that process. That is a punishable It is an offence which is punishable, and any person who forcibly prevents or obstructs any person making a proclamation is punished under Section 68 and is liable to imprisonment for 10 years.
In 2019, the Constitutional Court scrapped Section 36 of the Police Act on account that it authorizes and legitimizes police brutality against innocent citizens. In 2020, the Constitutional Court again nullified Section 8 of the Public Order Management Act, which granted the Inspector General of Police powers to stop public gatherings. Meanwhile, the police are on high alert following the violent protests that ravaged Kenya over high commodity prices.
During our eastern border with Kenya, especially the areas of Busia, Tororo, which are neighboring Kisumu, to help address any spillover effects that could arise out of the protests in Kenya that were actually announced by Mr. Raila Odinga. Of course, so like any other protests, there is always a potential violence, and for that matter, we do have contingency plans in place to address any security and safety concerns that may arise along our eastern border.
From the Directorate of Traffic and Road Safety, a total of 132 people died in road crashes in the last 2 weeks. Traffic Police spokesperson Farida Nampima states that a total of 787 crashes were registered.
From 6th March to 18th March 2023, 132 people died on our roads and 646 sustained serious injuries. These crashes occurred in the whole country. The areas that registered the highest number of fatal crashes were Kampala North registered 17, Kampala Metropolitan East registered 11, followed by Aswa Region that registered 9.
Meanwhile, in a bid to fight road carnage, the Inspectorate of Vehicles has automated all driver's licensing and testing processes to ensure that only quality and professional drivers are issued driver's licenses.
Drivers testing at IOV. Effective March this year, the attaining of driving permit CCs at the IOV testing center by learner drivers was automated. One, booking of learner drivers for testing is done online by the driving schools, and all learners are brought by the driving school instructors for testing. So, IOV is now automated. You cannot walk to IOV to be tested if you've learned how to drive. So you're booked online. by your driving school, and you're brought still by the instructor of your driving school to be tested at IOV. Secondly, at IOV, you're supposed to do online exams.
Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.